where are you guys going to stand by that yellow? Just go to where you would be.
What can you see of us right now?
Well, you're dead center, hang on.
What is it hearing?
That's pretty good.
Can you hear me right now?
Guys, we'll be starting in about 5 minutes. We've got 5 minutes before we start. That's what I'm saying. Alright guys, 3 minutes, so make sure you've got the water, make sure you've got your ball ready to go. 3 minutes and we're going to get started, so make sure you get yourself ready. Get your ball ready, get some drinks ready. 3 minutes. Ready to go. For anybody who's got any questions, we'll get those up as well. We can, at least this time, we're not videoing just the poll, so we'll answer your questions as well, okay? So, down to a couple of minutes left, so we'll be starting in a couple of minutes, okay?
You'll need one cone and a water bottle or something. Make sure you're ready. Be warmed up. Alright, hey guys, I know last time y'all only saw a white pole, but me and my friend are here today. I'm Garrett Garvin. I played at Midlothian Heritage, and I'm going to go to college at ETBU.
I'm Calvin Duggins. I play play also for Midlothian Heritage. I'm only a sophomore, but hey, I'm here to teach y'all some tricks that y'all can use in games that I use that are really effective.
Yep, today we're just doing CORE 360, which is some basic moves you can do in the game that'll help you get out of pressure, switch the play, do a bunch of stuff. We'll start with the Matthews cut, which is basically a single scissors, but people from England like to trick things up. I'll do it with my left foot, and Calvin will do it with his right. This is the Matthews cut. One more time. Okay, so what you want to do for the Matthews cut, you want to take two solid dribbles. You know, you don't want to do it just standing still. That's useless. So once you take your two dribbles, you want to lock your foot, and then you want to go around the ball with your left foot or right foot, whatever your dominant foot is. So I'm left foot, I'll use my left. And you also, once you land, you want to feint, so you can get the defender feinting. And if the defender doesn't feint, it's useless, because he'll just steal the ball right from you. So, ankle locked, around the ball, feint. And once you do that, your non-dominant foot pushes the ball away into space. I'll do it. Calvin will do it with his right.
Remember, keep your ankle, toe down, ball around, enough space over here, feint, push it out.
Good. Let's see. In a game, you'll use this like, you never want to use this in the back as a defender. Oh, if you get scored on, coach will be super mad. I play midfield, I use it all the time. Even when I play forward, I use it too, but I think personally it's best used in the midfield. You know, we got a lot of people diving, where midfielders are more likely to dive in than defenders, in my opinion, so it's a better move in the midfield.
I use it up top, you know, it allows me to, since I'm a striker, I can quickly get that defender to quickly go right there, move it out to the side, quickly get my shot off, enough time, you know, there's like, you have barely any time, especially at varsity level, to get that shot off, so if it's good to get it right there, rip your shot as a striker.
So on your lean, or your feint, you want to drop your knee, drop your shoulder, and you want to get the defender to go the way that you're faking, so you can push out that way. So you don't want to just do the move standing stiff. That's not good. You want to sell it.
So let's try for 30 seconds getting your foot around the ball and sticking, and dropping the knee, dropping the shoulder, make sure that defender will see that you're going that way, and then going there. 30 seconds.
All right, ready, Calvin?
Ready, go.
Keep your head up. Drop your knee, drop your shoulder. Good, 20 seconds. Let's go, keep going, you got it.
Keep on going, just keep it up.
Good. There we go, 10 seconds, keep going.
10 more seconds.
There you go, 5 seconds. Make sure you don't touch the ball. All right, good. All right, now take you a 15 second water break. It's kind of hot out here, I don't know about y'all. Whew. Man. The same move, I'm going to show you what not to do. Alright, move your ball. Alright, so number one thing you don't want to do is keeping it too close to your body, because it can just get stuck in between your legs, go behind you. It's just not good. And here's what you don't want to do. See, it goes behind me and it doesn't look good. Another mistake mistake is keeping your head down because you have no idea where the defender is. So if I'm just dribbling straight down, the defender's right here, I didn't even see him. Another thing is you don't want to get too close to the defender. Even if your head's up and you get too close, it'll have the same result of losing the ball. See? What you want to do is, best way to do it is to keep your head up and do it like two steps before you get to him, and really feign into it and make sure he goes the other way. I'll do it again. Good. So now, for all y'all kiddos, you'll need one cone, and for 30 seconds, I want you to go. I want you to attack the cone, do your move, accelerate out, turn around, and do the same thing for 30 seconds. And then after 30 seconds, we'll take a 15-second break and do it with your opposite foot. Ready? Set, go. Good. Let's go. 20 seconds. Let's go. 10 seconds. Let's keep going. Keep going. You got it. There we go. 2 seconds. Good. Now get you some water. Take you a little break. 15 seconds.
You go that way, and you go that way. Right there. Calvin, you're done. Right there. You're done.
Okay. Don't go outside of that, right? I was worried because you were getting, I didn't know if you were still in self-defense.
Alright, now we'll do it with your non-dominant foot, because I'm guessing most of y'all started with your dominant foot. We'll do it for 30 seconds again. Ready, set, go. This should be more challenging because it's your non-dominant foot. Perfectly okay to mess up. Just make sure you're doing it as fast as you can so you get better. Yep, notice how he's throwing in that little feint in there, making me lean the other way. 10 seconds. Good. 5 seconds, keep going. Finish strong. Good. All right. We'll take another 15-second break, and then we'll do it with our dominant foot one more time, and then after that our non-dominant foot one more time. Yeah, our example man's already tired. All right. We'll do alright, now we're going to start our dominant foot again, last time. Ready, set, go. Yep. Has that feint in there and he's accelerating away. Yeah. 15 seconds. Calvin, make sure you touch it further away. Good, accelerate. 5 seconds. Come on, finish strong. Good. 15-second break. Again, this is a great move to do, like I said, in the middle of the field. You've got a lot of people diving in on you. Not only will you make them look bad, you know, maybe get on the highlight reel a little bit, but it's a really effective move, and you can get forward really easily. All right. You should practice this almost every day, because, I mean, I do, and it's my go-to move. I'd practice it every day, both feet, for, you know, not even that long, 10 minutes a day, 5 minutes on each foot, I practice doing it. All right, so now we'll do our non-dominant foot for 30 seconds. Ready, set, go. Good. 15 seconds. Keep going, guys. Y'all got it. Make sure you're feigning. Keep going, guys. Y'all got it. All right, good. Good job. Now we'll move on to the scissors, which is the Matthews cut, essentially, but with two. So this is what it looks like. For the scissors, it's basically, it's like the Matthews cut, but for each leg. So again, take your touches forward so you're not standing still. Have your laces locked around the ball. Feint, knee down, shoulder down. And then with your right non-dominant foot, over the ball again. Lean over, knee down, shoulder down. And then with your dominant foot that you started with, push out and accelerate. Calvin, you do it too.
Toe down, around the ball again, push out, accelerate.
Yeah, make sure you accelerate to get away from your defender. And what I do to, what my coach tells me to do, get a water bottle, set it down, and for 30 seconds, just around, as fast as you can. Just like that. Calvin, you want to try? You don't want to knock over the water bottle. Treat it as your baby.
Make sure your legs are nice and wide whenever you do this, so you get that good effect on the defender. He's not knowing which way you're going. It's him wobbling. Split second, you're gone. You score a goal, you win the game.
In the game, I use this, as an attacking mid, I use it on the wings a lot, like on the sides, because it's, you attack the guy straight on, double scissor, he doesn't know which way you're going, you can go right or left, depends on what you start with. It's a great move out wide, and yeah, so what you want to do is do this for 30 seconds as fast as you can. And we'll do that. Ready, set, go. There you go, get wide and make sure you lean and feint. Good, keep going, guys. 20 seconds, y'all got it. Make sure you have your feet wide and go as fast as you can. If you knock over the water bottle, that's perfectly okay. This is a great, great move to do. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, good. Now take a 15-second break, and we'll do it one more time. Good break. Get some water if you need. All right. Ready, set, go. Good. 20 seconds, let's go. Pick up the pace. 15 seconds. 10 seconds. Let's go, finish it strong. Good. Way to finish. Again, I practice this move really often. Not every day, but probably 3 times a week. I don't use as much as I do the single scissor or the Matthews cut, but it's still as effective. Just probably a little higher chance of losing the ball than just the single Matthews cut. So I'll show you on what not to do with that. So again, like the Matthews cut, you don't want to keep it too close to your body, or this will happen. You know, it's just it sticks at your feet, and you don't want to do it standing up because you don't get the defender leaning. He'll stay straight with you. He didn't even have to move. And then again, you don't want to do it too close to the defender. You read it like a book. So what you want to do is get proper distance. You want to do it before he comes at you. So he dives in. I'll do it again. Make sure this is pivotal that you lean. You want to drop your shoulder, drop your knee, drop them, get the defender to go. So now we'll do it three times for 30 seconds. Full speed at the count. Or no, my bad. We'll do it two times on each foot. So let's start with your dominant foot. Ready, set, go. Good. Make sure your feet are wide. Accelerate, get a good touch out of the ball. 20 seconds. Keep it up. Seconds. Make sure you're feigning. 5 seconds. Keep going. Last one. Alright, take a 15-second break. This move is very effective. I prefer using it on the outside backs instead of the center backs because honestly, whenever I try it, usually they put their body in front of you and easily take it away, where the outside backs usually tend to dive in more. I think they're easier targets than center backs, but also center mids are easy targets to do it on because they like to dive in a lot too. All right, good break. We'll do it. We'll do it with our non-dominant foot now. Ready, set, go. Make sure they're wide. Good. 15 seconds. Good. 5 seconds. Good. So we'll take a 15-second break. Get right back to it with their dominant foot. Perfect time of the day to be outside doing it. Not too hot, not too cold. Perfect. Good little breeze. All right. Now we'll start with our dominant foot one more time for 30 seconds. Ready, set, go. Good. 20 seconds. Keep it up, guys. Seconds. Good. 5 seconds. Get one more in. Good. All right. 15-second break. There you go. Grab some water if you need. Alright, last one with your non-dominant foot. Ready, set, go. Get out of your feet, Calvin. Good. Ten seconds, y'all got it. Last one. Good. All right. Next one is the classic feint. Messi's favorite move and one of mine. So I'm left footed, I'll do it with my left foot. This move, it really relies, it 100% relies on your feint. If your feint's not good, then it will not work. So what you want to do, again, you dribble, take two or three dribbles, and then with your non-dominant foot, go as far, probably shoulder width apart, push your knee down, shoulder down, and then with your left foot, make sure your arm's up too, replicate a shot, replicate going to the right, and then with your non-dominant foot, push it out, accelerate away. And again. To use this, I meant, anyone can use this. Defenders could use it, forwards could use it. Midfielders especially, I haven't even seen a goalie do it. I have, it's scary. So, you can use it anywhere on the field. Like for a defender, you want to fake inside, go outside, pass the ball down the line. Midfielder can, go anywhere in between two players. This is a good move to do on the center backs. It's just a overall pretty, really good, reliable move.
I think my favorite part using this move is when someone's coming full speed at me. So when they're coming full speed, they can't control themselves. So if I fake that way, they're gone that way, that just leaves me wide open space right over there. I can just push my way, go and score.
So the one thing, a few pointers on what not to do. Again, it's, sloppy rolling over the ball in unnecessary time. So you do it. Like, roll up, come on, man. This is where you gotta be good. Also, again, not too close to the defender. Social distancing. But don't do it too close to the defender. Don't do it too early or else he'll read you. So, proper one. So, now what we're gonna do, Calvin's gonna do it for two times with each foot for 30 seconds. Ready, set, go. Good. Make sure you have a really good feint. That's what it depends on. 20 seconds. 15 seconds. Y'all got it. 10 seconds. Good, take a break. 15 seconds. Now, I don't know about y'all, but my favorite person to watch do it is Messi, just because he's so fluid and precise with it. It's crazy. I mean, he has grown men looking like little kids when he does it. All right. Now we'll do it with our non-dominant foot. Ready, set, go. Good. Make sure your touch is big after you feint to get away from that defender. Ten seconds, keep it up, guys. Two, one, stop. Good. Get some water, take a breather, 15 seconds. Yeah, I personally work on this move every day, like as much as I do the Matthews turn, just because it's probably my top used move. It just works so well. Okay, 15 seconds is up. Let's do our dominant foot again. Ready, set, go. Still does. 15 seconds. Y'all got it. Good. 10 seconds. accelerator. Good, stop. 15 second rest. All right. Again, get some water, hydrate. All right, 15 seconds. Get back. Ready, set, go. Again, this is your left foot, or, you know, who knows, maybe your right. Most people are right-footed, but it's okay to mess up. Again, that's how you get better. 10 seconds, finish it up. Good. Keep going, keep going. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. All right. I like it. It's just a simple rollover. So you're attacking, just roll over. Again, I'll do it for you. Alright, so for the rollover, same start as always. Take some dribbles forward. If the defender's, you want the defender, you only use this when the defender's running at you full speed. Once he does that, quickly roll your foot over the ball, touch it away. You want to make it as fast as you can so the defender doesn't reach his leg in and steal it. So you want to fast roll. Whenever I'm at home to practice this move, I just practice rolling it as fast as I can. Like that. So we'll do that for 30 seconds, just one time. Ready, set, go. Good. Make sure you do it fast. Y'all got it. Seconds. Good. Okay. More about this is something you don't want to do is when you do it, you don't want to do it super short like this. You want it longer so the defender doesn't get it. Because if you just do it like this, the defender's going to eat it up all day. I'm gonna get it long. So when I do it, long. That's the most common mistake, is it isn't long enough. Or you just do it too close to the defender. When to use this? I would not use it as a defender, honestly. It's you don't want to use it, it's a little dangerous back there, but midfield, definitely great move. Forward, it's also a great move. He's our forward for high school. He does it all the time, and it works very well. So we'll just start doing it with our, we'll do it two times with our weak foot and strong foot. 30 seconds. Ready, set, go. Y'all got it. Make sure it's a wide roll so the defender doesn't have a chance. 10 seconds, y'all got it. Three, two, one. All right, good. Take a little break. 15 seconds. Now we'll do it with our non-dominant foot. Non-dominant. Ready, set, go. he took the hat off, it makes his aerodynamics a little faster. Look at him go.
I can't see.
There we go, 10 seconds. 5 seconds, y'all got it. 4, 3, 2, 1, stop. Get you some water. There we go. Whew. All right. So now, what was that, Calvin? All right, now we'll do it with our non-dominant foot. Oh, dominant, my bad. Ready, set, go. You see, that's also a common mistake, getting too high on the ball. I've done it plenty of times, but that's why I practice it, so I can get rid of those mistakes. 15 seconds left, y'all got it. Five seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, last break, last little non-dominant, then we'll move on to our last move, our special move. Non-dominant foot, last time. Ready, set, go. Make sure you accelerate after that. Yeah, look at him go. 10 seconds, y'all got it, keep it up. As fast as you can. Y'all need to be making mistakes. All right, good. Take a rest while you need, but I'll be showing you the last move, the special move. Pretty advanced. So I'll do it with the left foot. Calvin will do it with the right foot. He's getting a drink right now, but I used to use it all the time. Still do, just not as much. It's the Maradona. So how to do this move? Take your touches forward, and with your dominant foot, place your sole on the ball. Whichever foot's on the ball, you want to turn your body that way. So if my left foot's on the ball, turn my body left, roll it back to my right foot, then continue to spin and drag the ball behind my leg. And Calvin will do it slow with his right.
You want to push the ball back. Fast, going in, not too slow, not too fast, or else that ball's going to be back there, defender's going to get it, you're going to get scored on, coach is going to yell at you. So simple right there, back around,
again, sole on the ball, you pull it back to your non-dominant foot, turn, and then with your non-dominant foot, you pull it away from. So when do you use this move? Personally, I use it in tight spaces, which a lot of people are around. I want to get out, and so I take a touch the opposite way. Since I'm left-footed, I take a touch to the right. Defender thinks I'm going to the right. Boom. Switch to my left, free space. That's when I do it. Again, do not want defenders doing this move. Do not want them. Midfielders probably the best, because as a forward, I mean, you probably want to do a little faster move than that, like a feint, but still, it's a really good move. So things you don't want to do on it, like Calvin said, you don't want to pull it back, because if you pull it back too fast, if you do that, the ball will be going flying over there, lose the ball, not good. So you don't want to... so you don't want to pull it back too soft. The defender has a good chance of getting the ball and stealing it from you. So you want to pull it back just right and then quickly turn. Alright. So Calvin will do it with his dominant foot, and I'll do it with my left. Ready? Set, go. 30 seconds. Oh, it's alright. Again, you're gonna mess up. It's perfectly okay. Good. 10 seconds. Or 20 seconds. Good. 10 seconds. Again, you can do this move various speeds. Alright, done. Take a 15-second break. You can do this move various speeds because it'll still be just as effective, because you can do it slow to bait the defender and then spin quick, and it works just as well. Good. All right, I'll be doing it with my left foot.
All right, 30 seconds, ready, go.
Keep going, guys. Y'all got it.
Yeah. 10 seconds. 5 seconds. Done. 15-second break.
Almost done. Alright, so let's go back to our dominant foot. Ready, set, go. 30 seconds. You should be feeling a little tired now. Perfectly normal. More mistakes will happen. That's all right. It's all good. Good. 15 seconds. Y'all got it. Keep it up. Finish strong. Seconds. 3, 2, 1. Good. 15-second break.
Another 5 seconds. All right, let's get back to it. Another 30 seconds. Non-dominant foot. Ready? Go. 20 seconds left. 10 seconds. 5. Done. Go ahead and take the rest.
That was it. So our challenge for you today, we want you to do that, the Maradona, which is our last skill. And we want you to send it in to us at Storm Football on Facebook. We want to see how good y'all can do it.
Make sure to practice these moves, though.
Yeah, practice every day if you can. All you need is a cone, a ball, water bottle, that's it. All right, guys, we'll see you Saturday and Sunday.
All right. So, guys, that's our second. The boys are doing 4 a week. We got 3 sessions by Coach Timo. Of course, we're trying to keep our distance in here. It is difficult sometimes, but make sure you're practicing them at home. So thank you to the boys here, and make sure you're tuning in Timo tomorrow. He's gonna be doing session 3 of the week for tomorrow, and then the boys will be back on Saturday and Sunday with the rest of our 360 skills. Thanks, guys, for tuning in.
Appreciate you.